Okay, in today's video, I want to run over testing Google's Firebase Studio. Now, Firebase Studio is a platform that Google has built, and it helps users build applications or prototypes super fast using AI agents. Specifically, it helps build both the back end and the front end. Now, I've never tested this before making this video, and I usually use things like Cursor or VS Code with Roo Code when building out different things that I want to try with AI, specifically like web apps, etc. So the plan for this video was to build a mobile application, which is basically a motivational quote generator that will be generated by AI. The user will be able to click a button, it will generate a quote, and then they will be able to interact with that quote and talk back and forward. So like I mentioned, the plan was to build a mobile app, but I ended up building a Next.js app, but it was still super cool to see the platform working and actually see how well it built out the application and how fast it done it as well. So if that's something you're interested in, then stick around and watch the rest of the video, and I hope you enjoy. So here we are on the Firebase.studio website. And as you can see, the first thing it mentions is the full stack AI workplace. So this is designed to basically help you speed up overall development from start to finish. As it mentions, Firebase Studio accelerates your entire development lifecycle with AI agents. It builds backends, front ends, and mobile apps all in the one place. So again, I've never used this before. I'm using things like Cursor as well as VS Code with Roo Code. That's some of the things that I have been experimenting with, and I'm finding some good success. I've never actually tried to build a mobile app, and I don't have a lot of experience trying to build mobile apps either. I do know about the different frameworks like React Native with Expo and stuff, but I've never actually tried to build one. So that's what I want to try and do with this. So here it shows you everything this includes, and it does kind of look like VS Code, or similar to like a code editor here. And this is what it looks like. So let's go into this and basically see what it does. So let's click get started. All right, so this is the main dashboard part here. And it's basically asking me, what do I want to build? And as I mentioned, I want to try and build like a motivational app, where basically the user can click a button, it will provide some sort of motivational quote, and then the user will be able to interact with that quote. It's very simple, and it will all be done using AI, at least that's the idea. I don't know if it's going to work. Again, I've literally never tested this. So you can see it's got the classic prompt box here, prototype an app with AI. You can add an attachment. It's also got some ideas with the looks of it. Like the tipping calculator, which is the classic thing people try and build, or like the to-do apps or the recipe generator. So start coding an app, you've got new workplace, import a repo, and then you've got the different languages or frameworks here, Python, Flask, Flutter, Angular, Node Express, Gemini API, Astro, MongoDB. So what we're going to try and do is use React Native plus Expo here. So I don't know what this is going to do when I click it. So let's see. We're going to just give it an app, and let's just call it test app, something like this. How would you like to open this app? Development builds allows you to write your own native code. Expo Go allows you to run the app on your phone. I really don't know, so I'm just going to keep it on the bottom one here, Expo Go. So let's give this a shot. So as you can see, it's setting up the workplace, and then it's going to initialize the environment, build an environment, and then finalizing. So while this is doing this, I'm just going to leave it be. I've actually got another window open here, and I have been prompting out this motivational quote app. So you'll see my first message here to Google's AI Studio. I'm using Gemini 2.5 Pro Preview, the latest one, which is at the time of making this video, 0506, which just came out like 2 days ago, I believe. So what I've told it here is, I need you to create me a prompt for Google Firebase Studio. I want to build a motivational quote app where the user will click a button and generate a quote. They can then talk about the quote to the AI, almost like a chat, if they wish to do so, and ask questions around. This is obviously not very clear, but I just like to give it as first prompt and then go back and forward a bit until it refines what I'm looking for. Also a few spelling mistakes in here or typos. So I want to use React Native and Expo. So it started doing its thing and running through its thought process, and it did build me out something like way too long for a prompt. So I'm not even going to waste your time reading through this. But basically, it was too long and too detailed, in my opinion, for what I'm looking to do. So as you can see, I've wrote, this is far too long, make it small to the point prompt. Again, it's done its thing. This is a bit better, a lot more to the point. It's gave me the prompt for Firebase Studio. It's kind of outlined the app. So one of the things after reading through this is it didn't really mention how it's going to get the quotes. How will the app get the quotes? Again, type on here, but you get the point. So then it's gave me ideas, storing the quotes initially. So this is basically telling me to like populate the quotes, which I don't want, right? I don't want to have to do the manual work here. The whole point is for this to generate them. So again, I'll skip this. I don't want them stored. I want the AI to generate them, or we can use an API. I was thinking there'll be some sort of API online, similar to the previous projects that I've done in the past, where I use like the Pokemon API, for example. So again, it's gave me a fresh prompt, and this one gave me two methods actually for getting the quotes. So it gave me the primary method, AI generated, and then external method. I just told it to remove the external one altogether, remove the alt method. And now it's gave me this final prompt. And this is what I'm going to try and use in Firebase Studio. So let's jump back. So it looks like this is done. And already I know that I've made a mistake, because I've actually not gave it anything to work with. I never gave it the outline. So let's actually go back and give it a prompt again. So if we go back to the dashboard, let's give it a prompt this time. So we'll give it this whole thing. I'm just going to copy this. And again, I've never done this before, but I'm interested to see what this does. So I'm just pasting this whole thing in here. And then I'm just going to click prototype with AI. So it's already got the workspaces and stuff done here. And let's see what it does. Now, this might take some time. So I'll basically fast forward the video here if it's going to take some time, and then we can see what it does. All right, so it's gave me a plan from this prompt. Okay, here's a plan for how we'll prototype this app. Take a look below and customize as needed, or if you're ready, select prototype the app. So this is actually quite cool. It's almost like a brief app blueprint, quarterly AI. It's gave it its own name. AI quote generation utilizes a cloud function to generate a unique motivational quote using generative AI. Quite cool. Quote display presents the generated quote. Does exactly what I'm looking for. AI quote chat enables users to engage in the chat about the displayed quote with another instance of a generated AI tool. A cloud function manages the chat interactions, providing context from the current quote to the AI. So that's actually really quite cool that it's outlined the features here. It's now gave us a style guideline, which is also very cool. Colors. Layout, I don't know if I can change these. Yeah, it's not letting me click on them. I thought that was letting me change them. I suppose I could prompt it further, but I'm not gonna. I think these are good enough to try. Clear and readable font, minimalistic. So that's actually quite cool. I mean, you could go further down here if you wanted, but again, I'm not gonna. I suppose you could just come in here and change it actually by clicking that little button up the top here, and then what I'm going to do is just click prototype this app once it loads again. So let's see what it does here. Again, if it's going to take some time, I'll fast forward it. Okay, so it's stopped at the moment, and now it's saying, okay, let's prototype this. So it's done its thing here, added all these files, etc. And now it's saying it appears that your app needs a Gemini API key. So, I mean, it's got an option to auto-generate. So let's see what it does. It looks like it's obviously populating this, which is quite cool. Usually you have to get this manually. And I think it has just gave me a version here, which is quite cool. still seems to be generating this API key though at the moment. So we'll give it some time here to see what it does after it's finished loading this. All right, so the first iteration of your app prototype is ready. Try it out in the preview window and describe the changes you'd like to make below. Want to make changes directly? Hit the whatever this thing is button at the top to switch to the code editor or click below. All right, well, let's try this. So it's got this quarterly AI here. Click generate to see an AI powered. So it looks quite cool. I just want to see what the different things are here. Share preview link, open in a new window, and then this one. Let's click this and see if it works. Embrace the detours, they often lead to unexpected masterpieces generated by AI. Discuss this quote with AI. So we can click on this. I'm not going to do this. I want to generate a new quote, see what happens. And this is actually very impressive how quickly it made this. This was like less than 5 minutes. Embrace the detours, they often lead to unexpected landscapes of opportunity. So that's kind of similar, actually. I would like them to be a lot more different, but let's try another one. Embrace the details, they often lead to unexpected visits. So they're actually kind of generating all the start, the same as the start. Yeah, they're kind of just generating the same one. Anyway, let's try, tell me how this relates to my job. I don't really know what I'm saying here, but let's just see what it does. So it looks like it's built the chat here. That's a great quote to consider in the context of your job. Think about it this way. Embrace details. They often lead to unexpected vistas in your career. Things rarely go exactly according to plan. You might face unexpected challenges, projects. So that's quite cool, actually. So let me try and just see if I can get the quotes to be different. Okay. So right now, the generated quotes are very similar. Can you make it so they are all different? Okay, let's try this and see what it does. Okay, this is the first test. I don't know if you can see this with my face in the bottom right corner here, but basically I've just gave it a quick prompt. Let me just move myself. As you can see, we'll put it back in. And let's click send to see what it does here. So I'll move myself over to the top. And let's see what sort of thing it works through. Okay, so it's already made those changes. You can see file changes. It tells me the actual file that it's changed. It's updated that. So let's give it another spin here. So I'll just move myself back down to the corner so we can see the interface. Let's generate a new quote. The universe whispers possibilities, dare to be the interpreter of your own potential. Quite cheesy, but funny. Let's try another one. The edge of discomfort is the horizon of growth. Step towards it. That one's quite cool. And it is different, which is also cool. So let's question this one. How does this relate to my love life? Just to see what it does here. This is a great question. Thinking about the quote, the edge of discomfort and the horizon of growth. Step towards it. In the context of your love life can be really insightful. Are there specific areas in your love life you feel struck on? So it's gave quite a long answer here, which is cool. And it's also gave it quite detailed. Okay, can you tell me how though specifically? Let's try this. I don't know if I spelled that right there, but let's give it a shot. Yeah, and you can basically chat back and forward to it. So it's quite cool. Let's try generate one more. The quietest bloom often yields the most potent fragrance. Cultivate your inner garden. That one's a bit weird, but okay, let's try another one. All right, so it's basically got the functionality. Now let's try one more thing. Let's make the styles all black and white and bold. So let me just show you what I've done again. So in the bottom right here, I've just said, let's make the styles all black and white and bold. And I will send this, see what it does here. So it's starting to obviously work on this. And this is amazing, actually, in my opinion. It is like super fast. It fixed that quote situation there very, very quickly. It was like in under 5 minutes again. And it's fixed it perfectly. So now I'm just going to try and change the style, see what it does. One thing to note is, though, this is not a mobile app, at least I don't think it is. I don't know how to use React Native, so we maybe have to put that in another video, but it has generated this sort of web app, which is cool, so you get the idea, and I'm sure we could change this into a mobile app very quickly, but it seems this platform is very good, in my opinion, so far, especially for people who are not very good at coding, and they just want something quickly, like maybe a prototype of a product or something. So over in the right-hand corner here, it is making the changes, which is cool. And then it's updated the app. And then it looks cool. It's got this sort of modern feel. So let me move myself over to the right-hand corner again. So the changes are done. And now it's got this sort of modern, almost like Shad CN look, if anyone knows what Shad CN is. So let me generate a quote. Yeah, and it's got this sort of cool. And I think that is like very, very good. It's built it quickly as well. So I'm very impressed with this Firebase Studio. And I believe that's all I want to show in this video. So I think I'll actually test this further, maybe in a future video with something a bit more complex, but I'm very, very impressed. And it still generates the quotes. Let's just check. Yeah, it's still doing everything that it needs. And I think in the future, we'll probably try publish this and see if we can actually get it into mobile app version. But for now, that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one.